My name is Steve Baskoff, and I work for the Digital Scholarship and Communications Office of the Jean and Alexander Hurd Libraries at Vanderbilt University. In this lesson, we will look at how the flow through a Python script can be controlled. If you've gotten to this video by some means other than through our lessons page, you should be aware that we have a series of lessons known as CodeGraph, which you can access by going to vanderbilt.lt/codegraph. For some of you, you may be continuing on to certain types of programming for which controlling the flow of the logic is extremely important. On the other hand, some of you may be investigating things like pandas and data visualization with pandas. And in that case, controlling the flow of programs is almost meaningless. So, because this is a feature of Python that only applies to some of the tracks, I'm saving it for last. It's not a bad thing to know about. So for some of you, it's just an introduction as a side thing, but for others of you, it'll form the core of additional lessons. To explain what I mean by procedural versus vectorized programming, the type of programming that we have done so far in Python is what I would call procedural. These are not strict definitions. This is just a convenient way to talk about the style of programming or the paradigm. So we have basically moved through different parts of the program. Sometimes we step through certain steps and then jump back for a loop. Today, we're going to see how you can go to a certain spot and make a decision and branch. And as we do this looping and branching, we may build and manipulate data structures, but the primary focus is in this flow through the program and controlling the movement from one statement to another. This is a very beginner sort of thing in Python. If you are doing something like pandas, which is what I would call vectorized programming, then the focus is really not on moving through particular parts of the program and jumping from one place to another, but rather on reading in entire data structures. And then when we perform operations, we perform them on the entire structure. We might do some kind of statistical analysis on the entire data set, or you might do some kind of visualization that involves the entire data set or the entire table. If the table is not the way we want, we don't step through the different parts of the table and change them one at a time, but rather we transform the whole table at a single time. And then we can take that transform table and do analysis or visualization with that. So for Python, this is kind of an advanced thing that we would not get to until after you'd finished a beginner course. But for R, this is the way that R is generally introduced. And so for R, you generally don't get into stepping through particular parts of tables or controlling the flow unless you get into more advanced R programming. So there isn't one method that's right or one method that's wrong. It's two different styles of programming, and which style is the best for you is going to depend partly on what you're going to do with the programming. If you need to analyze large data sets as you would do in data science, or whether you want to control the flow through a program, which might be something you would do if you were going to control the motion of a robot or something like that.